Hello.
Hi. Hi, how are you? Are you having a good time?
Absolutely. It's Comic-Con. Like, you know, fun time of the year. Very busy.
Oh, yeah. You know, I'm a writer and I work by myself every day in a room with the door shut. You know, so Comic-Con is like, I have. I've been to Comic-Con a number of times with the True Blood cast.
So, how was the experience of having another one of the series adapted? Like, how did it compare to in the first time around? Because obviously, True Blood was such a huge phenomenon.
It was.
It was such a, you know, warm response from fans, and now it's, you know,
Yeah, but there was a, and I've got a series on Hallmark too, Hallmark Movies and Mysteries. You know, True Blood wasn't a big hit right away. It had to grow by word of mouth. And so I had a little while to get used to it being on everybody's lips. And then, of course, there were people who just hated it. You know, my house, when I sold my house in Arkansas, they had it exorcised. Bad. You know, I thought, I feel pretty badass after that.
That is so funny.
Yeah.
Is there anything that you wanted to do differently in the way that things were adapted to the blood and learned during that process? Do you want to make sure that didn't happen here?
I think I learned with True Blood. I was, you know, totally new to the industry. I'd never met an actor. I'd never met anybody like Alan Ball, he's a unique guy, one of a kind. I just think the world of him. But I had never met anyone in the entertainment industry before. So I was terrified, you know, and that doesn't help. And now I feel just very casual about meeting people who are in entertainment, and not being scared really helps. That really helps.
So how much are you consulted with when they're going to take certain liberties with the material? You know, the producers were talking about how they wanted to speed up the pacing a little bit and add new fill-in. So, you know, how involved are you when they make those decisions?
I'm not really involved because they have to make the decision that's right for television viewing. I made the book, all the book decisions 100%. So I am glad to leave the making of the television show to them. They're the experts. I'm not. And I don't want to. I'm ready for them to ask me questions if they want to.
Was there any particular reason why, you know, we were talking a bit about this earlier with some of the other guests where, you know, obviously True Blood was on HBO, so it was a lot more graphic, and then this one's going to...
Yes, it was.
Yes. And then this one's going to be on NBC, so of course the approach to kind of the more sensual things is going to be a bit different. So was there any particular reason why it ended up with NBC?
They were very, David Gianlori was very enthusiastic about the material, and so was Monica. And I think the first prerequisite is people who really love the material. And I felt confident that they would stick to the spirit of the books, and they have. I think that's really all I could ask. As for being a little less graphic, I'm kind of glad about that. I'm certainly no prude, but sometimes on True Blood, as lovely as those people are, and really it was the graphic quality of the killing scenes that bothered me a little bit more. So I won't have to cover my eyes. No. It's for NBC. It's pretty much pushing the envelope, though. Definitely. I've seen the first 6 episodes. Yeah, and I'm still happy about it. Yeah.
How did it compare to your expectations of how you envisioned it would look adapted for television?
You know, I don't have expectations anymore because I'm waiting to be informed. I'm waiting to have that experience. There again, you know, this is my 3rd rodeo, so I'm just... entertain me. Show me what you got. You know, and they have. I've been very pleased with it. It's really a good show.
And what is it like for you as a writer when they're taking material from different books and sort of like...
Now, that was was really new to me. But there again, I thought, well, there are only three books. That's okay with me, really. It's not like they have to be sequential to make sense. They don't. So far, I'm going, okay, that was from book three. I think that was in book two. But okay, it's all good.
And then what are your thoughts on the potential longevity of the show, and then, you know, maybe if it completely veers off, like if they sort of exhaust what's in those books?
I don't doubt that Monica can make up enough good stuff to fill it up. I have no doubts about her creativity at all. And I really hope the cast and crew, I hope they're all employed for many years.
Having your work adapted into live action influenced or maybe changed your approach at all as a writer?
I hope not, because I don't think you can write thinking maybe this will be on TV someday and try to make your book more action figure type than it would necessarily be. That's not my job. My job is to write the best book I can, fulfill my contract with the reader, which is to provide them with the best book, the most entertaining book I can write, and anything after that is beyond my control.
Do you ever, I guess fan cast is the wrong word because you're the writer, but sometimes when authors have their work adapted, they kind of envision certain, like, their characters. Do you ever do that?
I kind of gave that up along with True Blood, too. No, because I want them to cast the best person for the role, not the one who looks most like the character in the books. And inevitably, I would think about someone who looked like the character as I described him. But I think you have to be able to see beyond that to the actor who can carry that character for several seasons if need be, and I hope they will have to. I'm on board. Of course, Peter was in True Blood also, and so I knew he was good, and he's got that gravitas, you know. I'm so impressed with Yule as the Reverend. There again, he's not the stick-like elder man that I describe, but he's, you know, he's got the presence, huge presence. And I'm just really, oh, and Jason is the angel. Oh, my gosh. He's so good. They're all good. Dylan and Parisa and Sarah and, of course, Francois. I'm just really, I really think they have gotten a really cohesive group that all stick up for each other.
So how do you feel about the fact that it's a really relevant bit of material to what's going on in today's sort of socio-political climate?
Oh, that's just totally a coincidence. You know, I think you write what's really pressing in you, and I think the fact that people need to band together to present a united front is pretty important, especially now.
Because a lot of the actors seemed really excited about playing the material for that reason, because they felt like it could really resonate with people.
I sure hope so. You know, when you write, I always have a message. Whether people get it or not, it's kind of up to them. It's not really, if people just want to read the books for entertainment, that too is fine, because books are entertainment. I'm in the entertainment industry anyway. But I do have a message, and I really hope it resonates with people and that it gives them a minute to think about it. Mm-hmm. I'm not a preacher.
What is your message from this series?
I think that people who feel like they're outcasts or different or not mainstream for whatever reason can find family and like-mindedness with each other. That's not exactly a new or startling message, but it seems like a message that needs repeating. Anybody else?
You were really thorough.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Ah, that sounds like squeezing an orange.